Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, Dr. Donna. Time for week 29:52. Last week's book was 9 Things a Leader Must Do. Can I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that although this book was a quick read, I really, really, really enjoyed it, and it was filled with many, many leadership tools and tactics that you can use to apply instantly to change how you operate on the daily basis. I don't want to give all 9 of them away, but I have selected the 4 that I believe will provide the most value to you right now. Number 1, play the whole movie. What does that mean? I say it all the time in my 60-second strategy videos that are on my YouTube channel. Play the whole movie out. That means that you take your current decisions and then you look all the way to the end and say, how is this decision going to affect me in the future? If you like the way that movie ends, then go ahead with that decision-making process. But if you don't, either change your current decisions or say no to whatever the deal is that you're being presented with. Number 2, embrace your inner insect. Now, I bet you didn't think you had an inner insect, but you actually do. In the book, he referenced the ant. And think about the ant and how teeny, 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 tiny the ant is, but how powerful the ant is because it is consistent. If you want to build anything, if you have these big galaxyspheric, hunormic, BHAG goals that I suggest you implement, you have to focus on doing something small every single day. They say, how do you eat an elephant? It's one bite at a time. How do you build a successful business and a successful career and a successful life? You focus on it every single day. And as I always say, how you do anything is how you do everything. Embrace that inner insect and you will accomplish your goals by being consistent daily. Number 3, quit self-exaggerating. I don't know how many times I have been to events where when I really used to attend a lot of networking events and everybody wanted to be larger than life and fluffed up and puffed up. That's not what real leaders, and in this book, deja vu leaders do. Stop attempting to be more than you are. If you want to be more, then you have to become more and you have to do the work consistently. Otherwise, all you're going to do is disappoint the people that you showboated to when they find out that you're a fraud. So don't be a fraud. Quit self-exaggerating. Do the work and really be humble about your results. People will be even more impressed and more excited about working with you when they find out that you are super duper duper fly and you kind of downplayed it in the beginning. Number 4, ignore the popularity polls. I'm going to say that again. Ignore the popularity polls. Now, how are you going to do that when likes and follows are just all so prevalent everywhere you go? You have to ignore the popularity polls because guess what leaders have to do? They have to make tough, unpopular decisions, and sometimes that's going to piss people off. I like to refer to this as the hard right over the easy wrong. If you're focused on being popular, you're always going to make the decision that everybody likes, and then you're still going to piss some people off, but they'll just say you're a nice person. Don't try to win popularity contests. Make the right decisions for the greater good, and in the end, people will get it, they'll understand it, and they'll respect you for it. If you have to choose between being liked and being respected, go for the respect. It's going to go much further. It'll take you longer and further into the run rate that you need to go into. Do I believe that this book has value? Absolutely. I recommend that you pick up a copy, and if you have a lazy loser in your organization, get a copy for them too. You'll be amazed at what reading this book will actually do. What is the book for this week? I'm glad you asked. It is The Prince by Machiavelli. I have been wanting to read this book for several years now. I'm glad to make it a part of this series. Looking forward to finding out all about the power that will ensue that Machiavelli said we need when we're in leadership positions. Well, that's my time, ladies and gentlemen. But before I get out of here, just remember, if it's possible for me, then it's possible for you. Watch what we do in 52. I'll see you guys next week. Adios.